Hi everyone. Today in this video, let us discuss how this hydralazine acts as vasodilator. Hydralazine is one of the drug which acts as both vasodilator as well as this drug can also increase the cardiac output. So these are the two quite opposite actions. Vasodilatory actions results in the decreased blood pressure, but at the same time, this drug can increase the force of contraction. How it is possible? So in this video, we are going to discuss how this hydralazine can act as both vasodilator as well as it increases the force of contraction. And again here, another important thing is that hydralazine mainly acts on the arteries compared with the veins. So this drug mainly produces the arteriolar vasodilatation and its action on the veins is very negligible. That's why this drug mainly reduces the diastolic blood pressure compared with the systolic blood pressure. And since the systolic blood pressure is not that much affected, so hydralazine does not produce any postural hypotension. So this drug, unlike the direct vasodilators, is not having the risk of postural hypotension. But how this hydralazine acts as vasodilator and how it can produce both vasodilatation as well as increase the force of contraction of the heart. So let us see it in detail. First of all, let us see the structure of hydralazine. Hydralazine is having the structure like this. And what are the functional group is nothing but the hydralazine. So this hydralazine group is attached to the one of the heterocyclic ring system. That is nothing but the thalazine. Now this hydralazine is having the thalazine ring system, which is attached with the functional group at the first position. So thalazine 1 hydralazine. That is nothing but the hydralazine. Now let us see how this drug acts. So at the vascular smooth muscle, let us see how this calcium movement is going to be controlled by different types of ion channels and receptors. On the vascular smooth muscle, one of the important calcium channels are the L-type calcium channels. Through these L-type calcium channels, calcium can enter into the vascular smooth muscle, which is responsible for the contraction. But at the same time, few of the calcium molecules can be stored in the sarcoplasmic reticulum, so from which calcium can also be released. Now, in order to release this calcium from the sarcoplasmic reticulum, it should express via the receptors. So, one of the receptors is the IP3 receptors, which are activated by inositol triphosphate. And second one is the rhinodin receptors. These rhinodin receptors are activated by intracellular calcium levels within the cytoplasm. So, now whatever the calcium entering into the vascular smooth muscle can act on the rhinodin receptors, such that it can activate these receptors, leading to more release of the calcium from the sarcoplasmic reticulum. In this way, small amount of the calcium can release the large amount of the calcium from the internal stores by activation of the rhinodin receptors. Similarly, calcium can also be released from the internal stores by another mechanism. Vascular smooth muscle is expressed with the alpha 1 receptors, which are the G protein coupled receptors. And when these alpha 1 receptors are activated, they will activate the phospholipase C system, which converts the phosphatidyl inositol biphosphate into the two important mediators, IP3 as well as diacylglycerol. So here, this IP3 can act on these IP3 receptors, thereby it can further release the calcium from the sarcoplasmic reticulum. In this way, calcium can also be released by action of IP3, and still few of the calcium channels can also be expressed on the plasma membrane. These calcium channels are activated by the sarcoplasmic reticulum. So when the calcium levels in the store is reduced, these calcium channels are opened to increase the storage of the calcium. And diacylglycerol can also increase the protein kinase C, which further increase the expression of the calcium channels. Thereby, calcium is more entered into the vascular smooth muscle. In this way, calcium movement is controlled by different types of ion channels and receptors. And the types of receptors are also present, SCR, CA. These calcium channels are activated based on the ATPase activity. By the action of ATPase, calcium can be stored into the internal stores within the sarcoplasmic reticulum. In this way, calcium is going to be transported in and out of these internal stores. But here, hydralazine is one of the drug which is going to produce a vasodilatation by interfering with these movements. Even exact mechanism is not known, but hydralazine is expected to block these inositol triphosphate receptors, thereby it inhibits the receptor activity, resulting in the decreased release of the calcium from the internal stores. When the calcium is not released, contraction cannot take place, resulting in the vasodilatation. In this way, hydralazine can produce a vasodilatation by interference of the calcium release from the sarcoplasmic reticulum. Now, hydralazine acts as a vasodilator by decreasing the release of the calcium from the sarcoplasmic reticulum. And this drug is more selective for the arteries. Therefore, this drug mainly produces the arterial or vasodilatation. So, that's why this drug mainly reduces the diastolic blood pressure. And systolic blood pressure is somewhat less affected compared with the diastolic blood pressure. And since it is going to decrease the diastolic blood pressure, it may reduce the perfusion pressure. And as the perfusion pressure is reduced, it can activate the sympathetic activity by reflex mechanism. So, hydralazine can stimulate the sympathetic system by a reflex mechanism due to the arterial or vasodilatation. Now, what happens when the sympathetic system is activated? So, hydralazine can activate the sympathetic system, thereby norepinephrine and epinephrine can be released, which can act on the organs like the heart, such that heart is going to be stimulated and they can increase the both rate of contraction, force of contraction, and as rate and force of contraction increases, they can increase the cardiac output. That's why hydralazine can increase the cardiac output, even it acts as a vasodilator. And this drug can also increase the rate of contraction of the heart, resulting in the tachycardia as one of the important side effects. So this is one of the action of hydralazine on the heart by activation of the sympathetic system. But this drug can also act on the kidney to increase the renin release. Now, raised sympathetic activity produced by hydralazine can stimulate the renal system such that the kidneys can release the one of the important mediator, that is renin. This renin is a proteolytic enzyme which can convert the angiotensinogen into the angiotensin 1. And this angiotensin 1 can be further converted into angiotensin 2 by one of the important enzyme AC, angiotensin converting enzyme. Now this angiotensin 2 can act as a vasoconstrictor, but here at the renal system, the role of angiotensin 2 is mainly to increase the sodium reabsorption. In this way, hydralazine can increase the edema by increasing the sodium reabsorption. What are the side effects? So few of the side effects are related with the vasodilatory actions, and few of the other side effects are related with the cardiac stimulation and sympathetic stimulation. So this drug can produce few of the side effects like headache, nausea and vomiting, as well as palpitations. By activation of the heart, it can produce the palpitations, awareness of heartbeat, as well as tachycardia. And because of the vasodilatation, it can produce the hypotension and diarrhea, as well as anorexia, loss of appetite can be observed. And this drug can also produce few of the hypersensitive reactions like the skin rashes. And particularly one of the important side effects that can be associated with the hydralazine is a systemic lupus erythematosus. So this is one of the immune reaction which results in the infection of skin, lungs, brain and other organs. So this side effect should be carefully monitored because it is a fatal condition which should be immediately controlled. So if any patient is developing SLE, systemic lupus erythematosus, then this drug should be avoided. What are the clinical uses? Hydralazine is not used as a main drug or a first-line drug in treatment of hypertension. This drug is particularly used for the treatment of severe essential hypertension. Again, in this condition, it is not a first-line drug. Whenever other drugs are not effective, then we can use the hydralazine in order to treat the emergency treatment of hypertension. Similarly, another indication is this drug can be given along with the isosorbate dinitrate in treatment of congestive heart failure, because organic nitrates like the isosorbate dinitrate can act as can produce a dilatation of the veins, whereas hydralazine can produce the arterial dilatation. So this combination can reduce both afterload as well as preload, thereby they can reduce the cardiac work. But this combination is not used in all the people, and only in few of the people this isosorbate dinitrate can be combined with the hydralazine to treat the congestive heart failure. So that's about the hydralazine. Hydralazine is a vasodilator, as well as it also increases the force of contraction, thereby it increases the cardiac output. The vasodilatory effects of hydralazine are mainly attributed to the inhibition of the action of IP3 on the IP3 receptors, thereby it inhibits the release of the calcium from the sarcoplasmic reticulum. In this way, it can prevent the vasoconstriction, resulting in the vasodilatation. But this drug is highly selective for the arterioles, so it produces arterial or vasodilatation compared with the veins. That's why this drug is less associated with the postural hypotension. And because of vasodilatation, hydralazine can stimulate the sympathetic activity by reflex mechanism. Thereby, it can stimulate the heart, resulting in the increased the rate as well as force of contraction, which increase the cardiac output. And this drug can also increase the renin release by activation of the sympathetic system, which results in the increased sodium reabsorption. In this way, hydralazine acts as a vasodilator as well as it stimulates the sympathetic system by reflex mechanism. So that's about the hydralazine. Hope you have enjoyed this video. If you like this video, please subscribe to our channel. Share this video with your friends. Post your comments in the comment box. Thank you for watching this video.